Welcome to this tutorial. Our first command is cat command, which is a short name for concatenate. This command is used for two purposes. First is to create a file, and second is to view the contents of the existing files. For example, if we want to create a file using cat command, we use a greater than sign and the file name. Okay, now type the matter you want to mention in the file. This is the sample file used to show examples. And now to save the file, we use Ctrl plus D from our keyboard. Okay, now to view the contents of file, we use cat command followed by the file name. Okay. Now our next command is cp command, which stands for copy. Now, if we want to copy the file student inside the folder test, we use cp command followed by the file name and the location where we want to copy the file. Okay, now to verify, we use ls command followed by the folder name. Okay, always remember the files are shown in black color and the folders are shown in the blue color. As you can see, we have a folder on our desktop and a file on our desktop. The folder shows in blue color and the file shows in black color. Now our next command is move command. We use mv to move a file or folder. Suppose I want to move the file student to slash root directory. Now as I press enter, the file has been gone from our desktop. Now to verify, we use ls command followed by the path. As you can see here, our file is now moved to the slash root folder. Okay. Now the mv and cp both commands are also used to rename a file or folder. For example, if we want to rename the test folder, we use mv command followed by the old name space, provide a new name here and press enter. Okay, as you can see on your screen, the folder test has now been test 1 2 3. Okay, but if you want to copy a folder, you have to use hyphen r option along with cp command. Now why I use hyphen r option? You can see using hyphen hyphen help, the hyphen r option is mainly used to copy a folder. See, as I mentioned in my earlier lecture, like hyphen r used for recursive. Okay, the same has been used in this case also. Okay, now if you want to clear your terminal, use clear command. Just type clear and press enter. Okay, our next command is history command, which shows you all the commands we used earlier from starting the system. Okay, now if you want to clear your history, use history command followed by hyphen c option. Now your history has been cleared. Now if you want to verify, use history command again. As you can see, you have used only two commands. Okay, our next command is head command. This command used when we want to see the top 10 lines or top 5 lines of any file, because this command works top to bottom. For example, If I want to see 5 lines of passwd file, which is the existing one in Linux, we use hyphen n. Hyphen n is for number of lines we want to see. Suppose I want to see top 5 lines of passwd file. /etc/passwd is the location. Okay. But if you want to see last 3 lines or last 5 lines of the same file, we use tail command. Okay. Followed by number of lines and the location of file. Okay. Now here are the last 4 lines of passwd file. Our next command is wc, which stands for word count. Okay. Followed by file location. Suppose I want to see how many words, characters or lines are used in the file student. Now here is the output. There are total 2 number of lines with 9 words and 46 of total characters. Now if you want to filter these results, we use 1 by 1. For example, if you want to see number of lines, we use hyphen l option, and the remaining syntax will be same as earlier. Okay, as it shows there are 2 number of lines. But if you want to see only characters, we use hyphen c in place of l. See, there are total 46 number of characters. And if you want to see only the number of words in the file, we use hyphen w option, which stands for words. So there are total 9 words in this file. If you want to verify, use cat command followed by the location of the file. See, there are 2 lines with 9 words and 46 characters. Okay, so that's it for this tutorial.